Hello friends, in this video you will learn the student engagement through gamification in online lecture with the live demo. For the demo, I am going to use the website nearpod.com. So you just have to type nearpod.com in the address bar, then you will get this page. This website allows us to conduct gamified quizzes. That means we can create a quiz and later on we can do the gamification of it in the live participation in our online lecture. So as soon as you come to this page, you'll find here you can create your own account, sign up for free by clicking sign up for free. You can create your own account free here. Otherwise, you can go to the another tab called as login here. So before that, I will show you the three parts of it. One is student who can join your lesson with the code that you provide to the students. Another is teacher. Teachers are allowed to create their accounts free on this portal, and there is administrator. Okay. So now we'll go to login section. In login section, there are two parts again. There is teacher account, teacher login, and another is student login. Teacher can log in with the help of this Google account, or another method is this with Office 365. Or if they have created their own account on this portal, they can enter their email ID and the password and they can log in by clicking on the login button here. Before doing this, they have to sign up there here by creating their own account. Whenever a student gets the join code, they can enter the join code here and they can join the live lectures. Now I have already logged in by my Gmail account, so I will directly click on login with Google and I will enter into this website. So as soon as I log in my account, so the another page will come on the screen. So there are different sections here. So this is the section by which we can create our own quiz into this portal, and later on we can do the gamification into it. So I have already created one quiz here, that is on data structure, on the module stack and quiz. I'll show you how to create a quiz into this portal. You might have created the online quizzes before also. The same way, we'll create the quiz here by clicking on create now. So as soon as you do that, you just have to type here the question. So the question is, how many days are there in a week? So you can provide the options here. 3, 4. Now there are only two text boxes by default. If you want to add more options to this quiz, you can just click add answer. 5, and then one more option is 7. So I have given 4 options to the students for this question. Out of these 4 options, you have to pick the correct answer so that the online assessment is done. So the correct answer for this question is 7. Click that and then just click on add question for next question for addition. So there is a save button here at the bottom. You will find the save button. Just click on the save button to save the quiz. Once you complete all the questions, you can just click on the save button and save your quiz. So I'm clicking the save button to save the quiz. Just It is just for showing you how to create a quiz. I have already created one quiz for this demo. I'll show you that quiz. So it is saving the changes done by us. So whatever the quiz that we have created now will appear here first, and the quiz that I have created before was on the data structure model quiz number 2. So if I want to do any changes to this quiz, I just have to click on edit button. So as soon as you move your cursor on this image, the options will appear. You can save the changes, you can edit the quiz, and you can preview the quiz. So I will first show you the edit option. Click on edit, then you select this. This was the quiz created. It is opening in edit mode. You can do the changes wherever you want. So all the questions are here. I'll show you all the questions one by one. So this is the question number 1. All the 4 options are given here. Out of this, you have to mark the correct option. Say I want to change this option. So say the another option is a correct answer. You can do that changes, and you can save the changes by clicking on the save button given at the bottom. So the correct answer is for this question is D. I'll keep it as it is, which is the linear data structure. So these are all the linear data structures. So the answer is correct. Another question with their options, then the correct answer, and so on. Likewise, I have created 10 different questions for this quiz. You can add more questions by clicking on the add question button if you want. So once all the changes have been done, you just have to click on the save button, which is given at the bottom here. This is saving the changes done by us. And again, you have to click on save and exit button. It is here. So we are on the first page. We have successfully done all the changes to our quiz. So it is appearing here. Now we'll move to the online lecture. It may be through any other platform like Zoom, Google Meet. There you just have to open one more tab in your browser, and there you just have to mention nearpod.com. Go to your account by entering your login ID and password. So whenever you are in the live lecture of Google Meet, you just have to share this screen and then go to the tab where your Nearpod account is open. So this screen will appear in the live class to the students. Then you can start your quiz by clicking. I will show you how to do the live quiz. Before that, I want to show you another option that is called preview. Click on preview. It shows you how the quiz will be shown to the students in the live participation. Click on preview. So it will look like this to the students. So this is the first question. These are 4 options. They just have to click on the button, correct option, and select the correct option by clicking on these buttons. This is question number 1. Question number 2, question number 3, and so on till the last question. All the questions you can see, you can preview how it looks to the students. Then you can click on the live participation to share the quiz to the students. So when you click on live participation, it will generate a code by which the student can join your quiz. You can tell all your students to copy this, that is join.nearpod.com, and enter this address into their web browser. As soon as they enter this on their mobile or laptop or desktop, the portal will ask the students to enter the join code. So in that they have to just enter this join code, that is BMKLR. So when they enter this join code, immediately they can join your live quiz and they can start answering the questions. As soon as they join the quiz, they just have to select one avatar in which they are going to play the game and attend this quiz. So as soon as teacher clicks on the continue button, the quiz started and it appears simultaneously on the screen of the students. They can pick the correct answer and move to the next questions and so on. So this way the game started, the quiz has been started. As soon as students join this particular session, you will find they will appear on the screen into this game with their avatar selected by them, and ask the student to write their proper name in the name section so that whenever that particular avatar comes, so it comes with the name of the student. So you will find all your students at the bottom level and they will climb to this hill at the top. As soon as they give correct answers, they will move towards upside. So their platform allows 40 students in free version at a time to participate into this quiz with this gamification mode. As we have not assigned any marks to any question, the platform by default gives the points to the correct answer depending upon the time taken by the student as well as the correct answer. So the student who gives the answer in less time, correct answer in less time, will always be ahead into the race. So there will be a race among the students and they will enjoy this particular quiz. So I'll show you the another section where students are participating now in the live demo. This is my live lecture on data structures. So I am presenting into my Google Meet. You can open another tab in which you can type the nearpod.com, login into the system, and this is your quiz. You can click on live participation. As soon as you do that, you'll get another screen where you get the code for joining. You can share this code with your students. You can ask them to type join.nearpod.com and enter this code to join this quiz. So I'm sharing this to my students in the live class in the chat room. Then when I click on continue, The quiz will appear on the screens of the students. Teacher can see the screen on the monitor, where he will get the details of all the students who are participating into this particular quiz. All the students will appear here. The first student entered into the quiz, next student entered into the quiz. Like this, 40 students can join at the same time. So we'll wait for all the 40 students to join. So now 14 remain to connect it. It will show you here that 21 have successfully connected to this particular quiz. All 40 students have joined now. After joining this, teacher can click on the start button to proceed for the quiz. Once it is done, by default 30 second counter is initiated for each and every quiz. There are 30 seconds given for student to answer. Teacher can see the leaderboard for all the participants, 40 participants here, with their names and the points they have secured into the quiz. The first question that appears will be shown into the another section of the screen. So all the questions can be seen here by the teacher. You can also see how the participants are participating. Here we see here all the students were at the bottom. Now after giving the first question answer, they are climbing up. So after every question, the students are moving upside. So there is a race among the students. You can see the points are also changing here. So right now Jay Chaudhary is leading in the class with the point 870. Now the second question is there. Students are giving the answers of second question. After second question, again the points have been changed. Till now Jay Chaudhary is leading in the class. Third question appear on the screen. After third question also, Jay Chaudhary is leading in the class with the points 2499. Now if you see, the another student has taken the lead after fourth question. Pranav Dave with the point 3346. So these points are changing depending upon the time taken by the student and depending upon the answer given by the student, whether it is correct or wrong. This is the scenario after fifth question. They are climbing up, you can see on the screen. So till sixth question, Pranav Dave is leading in the class. After 6th question also, Pranav Dave is at the top. For the 7th question is going on. Now, if you see, after seventh question, Shreya Bijam is now leading with the 0.5098. These are changing, so there is a good competition among the students, so they are enjoying the game. So with quiz they are also playing the game, so this is called as gamification of the quiz. We can say that all the students are participating with 100%. This is the scenario after 8th question. Shreya Bijam is at the top, 5847 are the points. Now 9th question is going on. After 9th question, again Shreya Bijam is at the top with the 0.6683. The last question is going on. After last question, the points are 7327. Again, Shreya Bijam is the topper in the class. Second is Pranav Dave, third is Janvi, Nambiar, and so on. There are so many students. So 40 students have participated into this quiz and they have successfully completed the quiz. So this way we can do the gamification of the quizzes with the help of this nearpod.com. You can scroll down and check the performance of all the students, how they have performed into this quiz. If there are more students in your class, say 80 students in your class, then you can do the same quiz twice. First batch with 40 students and next batch with another 40 students. So again we do the same thing. Again we click on live participation. For the next 40 students, the another code is ZUKJQ. You can share again with the code to your new students. As soon as they enter this into the portal, they will join. Here, click continue. After that, this screen will appear and we'll wait for this participant to join now. So the first student join. Now the students are coming. 40 students, next 40 students will join now. After they join, you just click on the start button to start the quiz. Now click on start button to start this quiz. Again, the leaderboard will appear on the screen of a teacher and the quizzes also. The first quiz, on first quiz, all the students are at the same level, at the bottom level. When they give the correct answer, they will climb up. Depending upon the time taken by the students and the correct answers, they will get some certain points by the platform. So that points will appear into the leaderboard. The student who gives the answer in very less time will become the topper of the class. Right now, Sony is leading with the points 849 after question 1. Now, question 2 is on the screen of the student. They have to pick the correct answer and then later on they will move up. This is the scenario after second question. After third question, Sun Mahesh Gowde is leading with the points 2, 3, 6, 7. Now the fourth question is going on. After fifth question, he is leading with 3, 5, 2, 3 points. After seventh question, he is leading with 4, 8, 1, 3 points. After 8th question, again he is also leading with 5, 4, 3, 9 points. The points for other students are also changing. Ninth question is going on. After 9th question, he is leading with 5, 4, 3, 9 points. Now it's changed to 6, 0, 6, 0 points. Now the last question is going on. After the last question, we'll get the leaderboard. We'll get first, second, and third ranked student. So we got our first three students, Sun Mahesh Gowde with the points 6, 7, 8, 2 points, Nainesh Rathod 5, 2, 8, 3 points, JS with the points 5, 2, 6, 8. So like this we can create gamification quiz in online lecture. Thank you very much for watching this video.